Hey everyone, you're with Tesla Tom. Thanks for joining me on Ludicrous Feed. I just got an email from Tesla over the last couple of weeks asking me to change my Powerwall 2 connection to Wi-Fi. I'm currently on 3G and there were concerns that once the 3G network goes down, then the Powerwall 2 won't work as well. But more importantly, they told me that if I don't change to Wi-Fi or Ethernet, then I void my 10-year warranty and it goes down to 4 years. So obviously I'm going to change to Wi-Fi. Now to do that, I need to go to the gateway, which is on the side of the house. Let's go over there right now. Okay, so I'm on the side of my house. This is the Powerwall 2 gateway. Now to get onto the gateway's Wi-Fi, you need to go to your device's Wi-Fi screen and select a network called TEG-3-digit number. So for my case, it's 299 or TEG-299, which is the last three digits of my gateway's serial number. So I'm going to do that right now. It's going to ask me for a password. Now the password is actually your gateway's serial number, which is up here. So mine is that number there, the second one after the QR code. It's got to start with an S. So if it doesn't start with an S like mine, you've got to put a capital S and then T, 17, etc., etc. Use that as the password. You should be able to get into the gateway's Wi-Fi. So once you do that, go into your browser. And in the browser URL, type in http://TEG- For my case, it's 299. Use your gateway's last three digits of the serial number, so whatever that might be. So once I'm into the Powerwall 2's UI, you can see that live here, what's happening with my gateway and my Powerwall 2. All right, so that's exactly what's happening right now. So I'm going to log in now. Okay, so to log into your gateway's UI, you need to use your Tesla email address as the account name, and the password is the full serial number, and again starting with a capital S if you don't have that already found up here in your gateway. Okay, so if you've successfully logged into a UI using your email address and your serial number, you should see a screen like this once you click on the network settings. So I'm currently on cellular. I've been asked to connect to my home's Wi-Fi, so I'll do that right now. So I'm going to click on my home Wi-Fi, which is 2.4 gigahertz, which is ludicrous speed, which is what I've called it. You can't use a 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi. It's only 2.4 gigahertz compatible. So I'm going to click on that right now and obviously put in my home password, which I'll do right now. Okay, so it's connecting to ludicrous speed, my home network for 2.4 gigahertz. During this process, you may have to reconnect to the gateway network to continue installation. This may take a little while. Okay, so I had to reconnect onto my gateway's Wi-Fi because it switched back to my home Wi-Fi. But once I did that, you'll see that I was successful with Wi-Fi at ludicrous speed. Cellular is also connected, so I guess they're just doing this as a fail-safe. In case the cellular goes down, you've still got Wi-Fi connection for your gateway for your Powerwall 2. And you can click on that to see that it is connected, so that's really good. Okay, so that's done. So my gateway is now connected to Wi-Fi and cellular. Alright guys, thanks for watching. That's how you connect your Powerwall 2's gateway to your home Wi-Fi network. That's the safeguard against any cellular dropouts, and one day when the 3G network does go down, you'll have Wi-Fi connection. Alright guys, thanks for watching. Don't forget to use a referral link if you're going to buy a Tesla Model 3, and also to like, comment and subscribe to this video and my channel, and as always, happy charging!
Thanks for watching, and thanks for being part of the energy revolution. If you haven't done so already, be sure to hit subscribe to stay up to date with our latest videos. Happy charging!